You mentioned Congressman Cantor. Obviously, he had a confrontation with the president yesterday. Mm-hmm. Are you disappointed with the way that he's conducted himself here? Do you think that he's angling for something bigger? What's your overall assessment of Congressman Cantor? I mean, he's playing such an important role, and this is a Virginia guy.
Yeah, well, it's you know, I don't know how to assess it from the inside, so let me just assess it from the outside. I want to see more of a willingness to compromise and solve the nation's problems rather than political angling. It is never the right thing to do to walk away from a negotiation table when you're talking about an issue that's of critical importance to the American economy. So when Vice President Biden convened leaders of both parties in both houses and they were working to, at that point, a $2 trillion deficit reduction, well, I thought they cared about the deficit. And when Congressman Cantor walked away and let a walkout of the congressional Republican leadership at that time, that's like going AWOL. You don't do that when you're in a leadership position. You don't abandon discussions that are critical. And so I just want to see more of a willingness to compromise. If you're asking others to compromise, you've got to listen to them and be willing to compromise yourself.
I mean, the White House, there's been Democrats that have signaled that maybe he should be taken out of this negotiation.
I don't think that. Look, he's part of the elected leadership of the Republican caucus in the House, and I think the elected leadership on all four caucuses in both houses, they need to be present and involved in this. But if you're going to be a leader, act like a leader. And leading is not backing away from a negotiation over a subject that is of critical importance to the American economy. You know, when President Obama came in, we were at the end of a lost decade in American life where GDP was shrinking, we were losing jobs, and the stock market was plummeting to around 6,000. The stock market, over 50% of Americans are in the stock market now, largely because of retirement accounts. Stock market's back up in the 12,000s now. People have gained their assets back in college savings and retirement savings. If this happens on the default, you would see people's savings overnight potentially plunge in catastrophic dimensions. This is no time to be playing a political game. You got to do the right thing for the American public and the American economy.